Hi everybody, how's it going? In the previous recipe of this data manipulation tutorial series in R, we learned how we can use the select verb for subsetting the data on columns, which returns only the selected columns and all of their observations. But what if we want to subset the data using rows? The filter function from dplyr package is used to subset the rows of data by applying the expressions or the filter conditions either to a single column or multiple columns to determine which rows or the observations of the data should be retained and returned as the result of such manipulations. Let's first load the tidyverse package, which will not only load the dplyr package but also all other packages which all together form the tidyverse. We can execute native function library to load the packages. Just like the previous recipe, in this video as well, we are going to use the same dataset that contains the data about employees. So when we execute the code as shown on the screen, it will download the data from GitHub and create a table employees_data. To understand filter verb better, let's take up an example and see how we can use it for data manipulations. Suppose we want to subset the data where gender is only females and store the result into another table, say female_employees. We can do it using filter verb and chaining operation using pipe operator as shown on the screen. So when we execute this code, we can see that female_employees table is created. As expected, this table contains the data only for female employees. Let's take up another case where we want to subset the data using some more conditions. Suppose this time we want to create a subset where employees are all males of age above or equal to 40 years and living in India, but whose salary in 2019 were less than $20,000. We will not store the result of this query but rather print it on the console. So let's do that using filter verb and chaining operation. Here in this code, we first created a subset for males and then passed it to next chain where we further subsetted the data for age greater than or equal to 40 and salary less than $20,000. So when we execute this code, we get the result printed on the console as expected. Also in this code, I have created a longer chain to explain the concepts, but we could have also combined all these conditions into one syntax using logical expressions as follows. So when we execute this code, we get the same result as in the previous case. We can even create a more complex case of subsetting using other expressions such as between and not equal to, etc. Suppose we want to create a subset of the data where employees' ages are between 30 and 40 years and they are not living in California state and also are married. So we can do it as follows. Here we have used between function from dplyr package that filters the data on age between 30 and 40. Just like as in case of x greater than equal to left and x less than equal to right expression where left is 30 and right is 40. Although there are many more things we can do with filter function by using different types of conditions and expressions in data manipulations, I hope you got at least the basic idea about this verb. Like I said before, there will be many more tutorials on advanced data manipulations where we'll be using all these verbs and other methods and functions together. So stay tuned. In the next video, we'll see the third verb mutate and its uses in advanced data manipulation in R. If you have any questions or suggestions, please write in comment section below and I will try to answer these as soon as possible. Also, please like this video and share with your friends if you think it could help them in learning too. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you have not done it so far. This would surely help me a lot and will keep me motivated. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and happy learning.